YouTube, we're joined by Deuce Myatt, and Scott's here again, I suppose.
What's good?
He's really here!
I have finally arrived, YouTube.
Oh man, that was an epic entrance.
That was all John.
Man.
For the love of God, here.
Okay, well.
Oh!
Alright, well.
This doesn't exist!
I'm so glad.
We got way more people than we imagined.
What? What happened?
Deuce is in there.
Deuce is behind John. You'll be hearing his voice.
Deuce,
but he won't be featured, actually.
John, move!
Oh, there he is! Oh, he's back!
There we go.
He's behind. Deuce? He was eclipsed, and now he's returned.
Okay.
Can we take this off?
I'm going to just point it at Deuce the entire time.
Hold him up. We're here at Epik Table Talk again.
Epik Table Talk, is that what this is called?
Yep.
You wouldn't know if you had been here any of the previous
have
weeks.
Have attended any of the times you said you're
you don't really care.
I was here last week.
No, you were here last week.
I was an alien, the Toy Story alien.
That's my man's. Anyways, Billy, what are we talking about today?
Well, let's first talk about the thing that happened just as fast this weekend.
What is that nasty ass stain he got on his
Well, apparently, when I was eating, there was some,
establishment.
Some stuff got on my jacket, apparently. Thanks for pointing it out, though. It's great.
Always good to be positive
anyway,
and show your friends
that if they're dirty at an event, and they got to stay on them. Let them know. Don't let them not know. Yeah, well, you know what? We'll take the time to take this jacket off.
Ooh-hoo-hoo.
It's getting a little hot in here. I'm getting a little angered. Anyways, moving on to stuff that has, you know, important and actually matters to people in the Yu-Gi-Oh! World. The set released this weekend. Pre-release.
Sneak peeks for everybody. I didn't get to go.
You were tied up?
I had 14 shots the night before. Thanks, stream.
Okay, but I went to like sneak preview and stuff, and everyone, you know, getting the Zodiac cards. It's pretty crazy.
That's cool.
What did you think of the sneak preview stuff?
I actually did not get to go to the sneak peek.
Oh, you did not?
Nah. Didn't go. I would go.
What about you, Deuce?
But I didn't get to go.
Everyone just completed the deck that wanted to complete the deck.
Who said that?
Okay,
awesome. It was a joke.
Wow.
Go ahead.
Wow. Right.
Oh, you're good. I can see you. All right, go ahead.
Whoa. Weird. But, and awesome. Like, people were just buying the deck at whole.
Really?
So, yeah.
They just came in and basically bought a house when they walked in. That's cool. Well, good for them.
I got ridiculous trades for no reason because some guy really wanted something.
What was the juiciest trade?
You don't want to know. The juiciest trade had nothing to do with any sneak sheet cards. It was literally a guy who traded first off.
Who's trading? Random guy B and you?
Yeah.
Well, what did random guy B trade you?
It was just a trade. It was just a good trade.
No. I want to hear this.
First off, the trade was already even.
Okay, fair.
Hold on, even.
Go ahead.
Take some more cards. Take some more cards.
Take $15 worth more cards.
Sure.
But at his prices, that was definitely probably like $60 worth in cards I picked up.
Oh, cool. Good for you then.
But no, I was able to get, you know, a couple of barrages. I ended up trading out to people who wanted them more than I did.
Okay.
This past weekend. But I did end up with one Rat Pierre for my deck.
What?
I had one. Nice. I think it's a good start to to the Zodiac engine.
Oh, for sure.
That I'm gonna need.
Yeah,
I think
standard.
I think I'm pretty close.
Yeah. I think you just start with one and it becomes.
I didn't get the Wild Bow or whatever his name is, the Broad Bull. What's his name? Broad Bull's the secret.
Wild Boar now.
Borbo. Well, he's a rare, and I wasn't able to get him. I wasn't able to get the two other Rapiers or
his
any
name.
Whiptails or
he
any
also had
Drydens.
Like three barrages.
Yeah, at one point.
Did you just trade for them or buy them or what?
Oh, I traded for them.
Did you get the shaft?
No.
You can be honest here, Billy.
No.
You can be honest.
I always give too much in my trades.
Oh, no.
But it's always great. Just come rip me off anytime you feel like it. Feel free.
Okay. I'll do that right now.
Anyways. so is that all we're going to talk about? The sneak preview? The set comes out this weekend.
Does everybody have the
changes?
Oh, it's really cool. Konami Europe's actually replacing all the misprinted.
Oh, yeah,
PCSs.
I heard about that.
They're giving out the proper tuner name, so anyone can send theirs in and get the one with tuner. So maybe it's going to be kind of like something that's not going to be seen as much, and people will keep theirs, and it'll be
worth a lot.
Day.
A lot, yeah. That card's pretty good. Not as good as what they thought it was going
to
be.
I thought I was also turning into Deuce for a second. I was disappearing. So I'm leaning forward.
Scott's eclipsing.
I'm just
Am
kidding.
Am I eclipsing Billy?
I was leaning backwards. Bro, I eclipsed this whole table. So, just kidding, guys. Sorry.
See, when I'm here, tough crowd. Stuff like that cannot get away.
Yeah, Scott doesn't let me get away.
That stuff does not fly when I'm around.
Scott's known me for too long to put me in check.
So anyway...
Speaking of whatever is eclipsing and stuff, next week we're going to talk about the best players of all time.
Oh yeah,
interesting.
This is my idea. I think this is a good idea. Oh, by the way,
why Scott not show up for his idea?
Fuck Weird. Champ Trade. We're not going to go by Champ Trade.
Ooh, Jesus. That's a strong word.
Sure,
I think it's
they
solid.
Just go by. No, it's but, not. I mean, it's a bunch of nonsense. But okay, anyway,
a bunch of nonsense.
Literal nonsense. All I got are Champ Trade. All I got are Champ Trade posts. And I don't agree.
I will say I heavily disagree with a UDS being. The same as a non-sanctioned tournament.
So we should have rules. I think there should be rules to this. My number one rule is no cheaters. So.
Ooh. Oh, God.
If you've been
Yeah, okay then. Fuck them. They're dead. They're done to me. I think it's fair, right? To just knock the cheaters off? So, like, no Adam. Who else?
The list got so, like, it's a lot shorter.
Yeah, the list got a lot shorter.
There's Iman.
Jesus. Okay, I'm not going to say any names. But
next,
anyways,
Billy,
that's
next.
Something to look forward to next
no,
week.
No, we're all going to make our own list, which I think is really
yeah, we're
going to
make our list in
Mine's
going to
be super
time.
Biased. So, all my
See,
friends,
after
but
today I found out one
is.
Person does not belong on the
Hearthstone God, shout out to Jake. Rank one right now. Rank
one today. Rank one legend today. Rank one legend today. No big deal. Humble brag.
No, it's not that big of a deal. It's just,
not a big deal.
It's just a huge deal.
Just another day in the office.
Just another day. Master. Hearthstone Master, Jake.
Super subtle shout-outs. Alright, moving on to something I really want to talk about. One of the greatest things that's happened to me in the past 26 years. Oh, wait. That's my entire life. And that is the newest Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie, Dark Sides of Dimension. It has changed. I don't know about you guys, but a lot of people play this game and it's a hobby. But for me, it means everything. And I have somehow resulted in, like, living my life just like, you know, the children of Yu-Gi-Oh! In the TV show.
Yeah,
so, like, I have
absolutely.
A very emotional...
Oh, you're
a
main character?
I am
he
the
is
main
Yugi.
Character.
He is
yeah.
Yugi.
Oh! I tend to at least believe that. It's kind of like this... It's like a psychosis
that.
I have.
I believe that.
Yeah. And so every time he says something that I think, I get a little teary-eyed. So, needless to say, I was crying through the whole movie.
My
like,
favorite part
baby.
Of the movie was when Yugi won the duel at the end. She was insane. I love that.
Dude, how did you know? He was, dude, what about when Kai was sacrificed? I'm just kidding. I'm not gonna...
Yes!
I'm sorry, I thought you said you've seen it!
You're lying!
You just said you
No, you just said the
You
ending.
Said it!
Are you
oh,
shitting
my
me?
Bad. No, but it really is one of the best movies of all time.
Have you seen any episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! Ever? Yu-Gi fucking wins!
Spoiler!
Okay, let's be serious for a second. Let's be serious. Does Kyber really sacrifice himself?
No, this was a joke, bro.
Be honest with me, Jack.
Bro,
you
it
can't
was a
lie
joke.
To me.
It was a joke. It
no,
was a
Billy.
Joke. Moving
no,
on.
No, 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 no. I'm pissed.
God knows I can't lie.
Yeah, she can't lie. Does but, he sacrifice himself for the greater good?
No!
Wow! No! I'm so mad!
It's one of the greatest movies of all time. I've changed my life. Wow! Stop spoiling it for him. I only said the word sack. I was talking about a sack flying like a bunt. Like he
like what?
A, like the clean card sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
We were talking. It's real good.
You have to watch it if you haven't watched. It's one of the greatest movies I've ever seen. Cry the little thing. Best movie ever. Might be my favorite movie of all time. What do you think about Dark Sides of the Dimension?
I liked it till you know we were in the theater and Billy tosses his soda across the theater.
Oops. It was just first of all it was water. Second of all, it was a studio movie girl with a
so
small.
So this did happen?
No, it's. I'm just sitting there, and all of a sudden, the next thing I know, my bottle of water, it's not a bottle, it's a glass, a plastic cup.
Oh, it glass,
just,
yeah.
It like skyrockets, like diagonal down the thing, and you just hear, oh, yeah. And water's like all over the floor,
so,
and weird. It was.
So, because of the release of the movie, they came out with these like little keychains.
Oh, yeah, those are sweet.
These are pretty nifty ones.
Is Bakura on there?
No,
I'm gonna show like the
player's
the
most broken one.
What's that?
If you show this player camera, it'll show up.
Oh, that's badass.
Ooh, check out these little guy
toys. Yeah, the Yugi is awesome.
Yeah, you can get them online too.
But yeah, Dark Side. Did you see?
Man. Yeah, I saw it.
It was broken, right?
From what you told me, apparently it's your biography. So.
Exactly! Dude, when Yugi's like, no, I think I'm gonna stay here at my grandpa's store and play Yu-Gi-Oh! And help him around the shop, create my own game. Oh my god. and then he's like, say goodbye. Until next time.
stuff.
I'm sorry.
Okay, can we move on to the next subject, please?
Next subject.
I'm so mad you ruined the movie for me. Oh, God, I'm sorry.
Spoiler free. You said you've seen it. Sorry that I assumed.
He actually
that's actually not the ending, though, so you're okay.
He definitely said don't spoil it.
Yeah, I legitimately said 5 minutes ago. I haven't seen the movie yet. So I don't want to hear. And you even said, oh, let's go see it.
You've always already spoiled one thing. How about the true
Scott,
ending?
Scott,
are
you trying to see
it? Yeah, you want to
hear
it?
No, I don't want to hear the ending.
Okay.
Are you trying to see it with us this week?
I'm down. Unless, maybe. We'll see.
So, not a true fan. Anyways.
I'm a fan.
John, did you enjoy Dark Side Dimension?
It was amazing. 10/10 from a Yu-Gi-Oh! Perspective.
What about a real life perspective? I don't have a Yu-Gi-Oh! Perspective. I have a life perspective. Everyone's got their Yu-Gi friends and their friends. They're one and the same for me.
Nice.
What I'm saying is a player. Like, if I didn't know, if I didn't play Yu-Gi-Oh! And I went to the movie,
I still
would have
been
I don't think I would. If I'd never played Yu-Gi-Oh! And I went into the theater...
Yeah. Duelist. Like, what part do you want to know that was the best? Yugi, come duel me. There's every part of that movie is epic. That was me telling about what happens without explaining with you, but if you see the movie, you should know exactly what parts I'm talking about. That's a light pitter patter. Yugi, that's kind of alright. Anyways, moving on. I really love the movie a lot.
Clearly.
A lot. Ah, in a couple weeks, we have YCS Seattle.
Who's winning that one?
I don't know. TBD. TBD. But I got some guesses.
Guess? One guess?
I got a guess. I got a rumbling.
Guess is guess.
I got a rumbling in my tummy. I guess we can win YCS Seattle. YCS Seattle. I'm excited. I love YCS. First American YCS of 2017. Kicking off with a bang at YCS Seattle. YCS Atlanta is the second one in March. Less than a month away. It's only three weeks maybe after Seattle. Yeah, so the YCS season is starting. Yu-Gi-Oh! Competitive dueling is on the rise. I'm excited. Are you excited?
You're a little too excited right
now. We talked about the Dark Side Dimensions and it's got me all kinds of hyped
up. I'll be in Atlanta. I'm not going to Seattle, unfortunately.
Unfortunate.
I don't know. Billy and I have the goo.
The goo.
Oh, you got the goo?
The goo.
Oh, we got to show you the goo after this. We didn't show you the goo yet.
I didn't even know how many cards
we have. The goo. Robert Magnetophos goo.
Oh, we got Magnetophos?
Yeah, no.
We got the Magnetophos goo.
No, oh, wow. He is broken.
Yeah, then Robert Seattle's dead. Yeah, Seattle's just screwed.
It's over. Yeah, it's done for.
Is Robert going?
No. He's too successful. He has too many cards, though.
Yep, I understand.
Deuce, you excited about Seattle?
Yeah,
the competitive season?
Are you going to Seattle?
Yeah, Seattle's going to be crazy.
Excited, new set. Are the Zodiacs going to make an impact in Seattle? Do you think they will affect the meta?
I mean, they're in every
deck.
LCG, so,
So out of the top cut, how many decks do you think will have Zodiacs inside of them?
Honest to God, 32.
32 Zodiacs. Not here.
No, I bet.
26.
I'll take you over.
So you think it's going to be six decks
gonna
that
be
don't
six
contain
cards.
Zodiac cards in them?
No.
Which decks
not.
Would those be? Blue Eyes on Dragons?
Perhaps in the Voids.
That plays. I'll give him that.
The 40 card version that
some
you
people
said?
Don't play it.
Like
some people don't play it.
Just lawn mowing that just goes second.
Yeah, there's some people that just don't play it. Yeah. But they're not going to make it because they don't have fucking what they're called in their deck.
No, yeah.
They
take the under on 29. I would say
I'll take the over on 31.
Yeah, see, I'm close. I think at least 30.
I'll take the over on 31.
Yeah, no, I think, yeah, I understand.
32 decks.
Yeah, I understand. I think it'll be like 30.
DDD, what's that? Like an okay matchup?
Mermail Zodiac. They use Zodiacs.
Oh, they do now?
Every single deck uses Zodiacs.
And you get to make a level 3, a rank 3. It's broken.
Bet I won't have a deck that won't play. There's one deck that won't have a DDD.
DDD? Yeah. Ah, so there could be DDDs.
Well, you are DDD if you play that deck because you don't play the fucking.
Fire score is insane.
It's insane against pure Zodiac. You tribute a dark monster with 2,000 or more attack or defense? Attack, right?
Defense.
Yeah, it has a defense too, and it does defense. Yeah, and then does 1,500 or less defense.
I would like to say that I think all of America is behind. I will say that now because Japan has had the deck for what, like 6 months, 3, 4, 5 months.
Yeah,
and everybody just plays pure, and nobody's playing pure.
Well,
here.
Not in the beginning. It wasn't. There was a lot of pure, but it wasn't. It was a lot more
right
diversified.
Right now is all pure.
Yeah, I know.
In Japan,
their balance is completely different from ours.
They just don't have Kieran.
Don't have Kieran. They have one of each of the slimes.
ABC,
or like one of the slimes.
How'd
they
do
the
ABC?
Union Hanger?
Hangers at one.
Oh, I didn't know that. Well, that kill it? That sucks anyway. So that doesn't really matter.
ABC Zoo?
I mean...
No. No. That deck sucks ass.
Buster Dragon.
No. Buster Dragon sucks because you only make it like 60% of the time. You always make Drancia.
That's fair.
No, I will say... I think Pure might not win this tournament, but... Pure has to be like the best version because everybody plays it over there.
I'm tempted to believe it, but like it just seems so very fragile.
We have a cure,
right? That's why I think Metal Foe is to me the best deck. I don't think it's close.
Yeah, I think Metal Foe Zoo might.
Oh man,
that deck can perform a pendulum summon.
I think Metal Foe is like the most resilient because like you have Magic Spectre cards that don't lose the slumber. You have Nithrilium that doesn't lose the slumber. So all those cards like don't lose the slumber and Kaiju's. So like that could be good. Plus you like consistently have two.
It don't matter. And Kieran is just so good. Ass beat.
And another thing is they have this mechanic. It's called.
Oh no, Scott.
What is it called?
What?
Pendulum summoning?
I've never heard of it.
You're gonna see it, Billy.
Oh, is this when I have to go the scales back and forth and I swing the pendulum and then I summon all my monsters?
Oops. Attack for 8,000.
Pendulum 5.
See, I was a very strong believer in pendulum summoning
until when?
It's
been dominant for a year.
No, there's this card that got released. It says, ignore special summoning conditions.
Oh, the trap?
Void Feast, he says.
But that deck sucks ass in Japan, too. It does!
Technically, we are missing a card, which is the.
The Hiroko. And that card's insane, too. We don't have Hiroko.
The other entity card.
Oh, Natis?
Yes.
That card's insane.
Natis is very good. Are you okay? Billy?
What? I'm pondering. I'm listening.
Is Billy going to be playing in Seattle?
That's like the most asked question. I can't tell you guys he's competing.
Pure Zodiac.
I don't know if it's the best like deck right now because we might not know all the plays, but Japan...
Now I know that I'm definitely not playing My Body as a Shield.
My Body as a Shield is good. It's a good card.
It's good and bad decks.
That deck's not bad.
I know.
It literally wins every single tournament in Japan.
I'm aware.
So, there's no reason that
they have more cards. They have another set that has another guy in it that's broken.
What is it?
It's the other guy that summons another dude. I'm telling you, they have another guy that summons another dude. I've seen the combo videos. Leica.
I don't even know.
Leica summons Leica from the graveyard, but you can't use it for next.
They have a whole other set. It's a completely different format.
It's been like that for a while.
I'm dice with you. Instead of done, I'm dice.
Roll a 5.
Woo! He rolled a 12, boys. Okay, anyways.
All I'm saying is, I think we're behind.
So YCS Seattle. We're behind.
I think we are behind. Everyone I've talked to has just been playing pure.
Everyone.
Really?
I don't know why.
Everybody I've talked to is not
playing. From around here. Not from around here. They're pure kaiju.
Pure kaiju, one or the other. There's never.
I think it's like the same shit. I think pure kaiju.
It's very similar.
I think Jack's Metal Foe deck is insane.
Jack and Cam.
Yeah, Metal Foe is very, very broken.
It's solid.
Jack's Metal Foe deck is insane.
Why, Jack?
It's different. Yeah, it's different.
I can't remember.
But yeah, I'm super excited to see what happens. Zodiacs will be in everything.
Is Cam going to Seattle?
Probably.
I don't think Cam's going.
I don't know. I think so. Next thing we talk about, IRL only. In real life only.
Yeah, that's very important to me.
There was like a new, some emulator thing for Yu-Gi-Oh! It's cool to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Online and stuff. It's awesome to watch. A lot of people got like upset because a lot of people were talking about preferring to play in Unreal Life only and not being able to play online.
See you, John.
John's tagging out for a minute. But it's not really that big of a deal. I do like playing in real life and like going to locals, you know, and supporting your local hobby shops and buying the cards and sitting down and playtesting and hanging out with people. But obviously it's more effective to get games online and getting to grind them out, you know, online. It does suck that we don't have like a platform to do that on that supports the TCG as much as we could.
Unfortunately.
But what do you think about this whole...
I love a new thing.
You love it? You think it's a benefit for the game?
But how do you... Yeah.
I think it's a benefit for competitive play and increasing competitive players.
I can talk about this for a while.
But...
It's worth.
But, like...
Did anybody see Jeff's status?
Yeah.
I think that was... Jeff's my boy.
For the people who don't know, can you explain it?
Well, Jeff had a status that there was an online software that died, and it was good for the game. And I just could not disagree with that anymore. It does not benefit the better players like Jeff. Because if they don't play, but it only makes everybody better. And I don't see how that's a bad thing to me. When you're only playing, like,
you're competitive wise, you're right.
Yeah,
but not for the health of the game.
No, it is good for the health of the game.
Sort of.
It makes everybody better. How is that bad?
It's good for the health of the competitive game.
Yeah.
But not the game in an aspect that doesn't get, it gets less people in the, like, foot of doors of locals, buying the cards, buying the packs to practice with the cards. It's the reason why the prices all spiked on the cards when the old, like, thing emulator you'd play the game on went down. Everything, like, skyrocketed. More people started attending locals. And guess what? When more product is selling, the game is being more successful. Like, that's how the game grows.
But the game is successful anyway.
Yes, but it could be, yeah, but it could be more successful without it. But you're right, from a competitive standpoint, it does increase competition and the skill base increases.
Yeah, absolutely.
But even if the skill base increases and then the people in the stores, like the product sells less, it kills you, taking it out from the bottom, and then it falls forward. And no one, we don't get the tournaments to be competitive at anymore because of the game, you know, being used improperly, sort of.
Yeah, I've seen from like a competitive standpoint, uh-huh. It's like the formats get solved faster, so people get bored of the formats faster.
Right. Yeah, I mean, that could be a thing. There's always more to learn, more to change.
Adapt.
Yeah.
Always.
Yeah,
I think
that's great from that side.
That I don't like that argument because Dragon Ruler format literally changed every day. Every single day. When the first Dragon Ruler came out, it changed every day, and it was, everybody says it's the best format ever. I don't think it is the best format ever, but it's up there. Every day it changed, and every day you had to adapt, and that's good.
What do you think, Jacqueline? Jay Quillen?
Starting from an online standpoint and having to adapt into the IRL thing, you get significantly better in real life physically touching everything.
The old emulator.
Uh-huh.
There was the old emulator, right? And then it went away, right? And then everybody I'm getting like roasted for this. But it's the truth. Everybody sucked ass. Like, they just sucked so bad.
It seemed
bad.
That way. It seemed like
I literally talked to YCS because all my opponents were just terrible.
Yeah.
If Dean was around, I would have lost. It's just that simple, so.
Yeah, but it's all from a competitive standpoint, not from, like, the game growing.
It puts you in really
but
bad
habits.
But
the game is... The growing
explain,
game
explain
doesn't make any sense.
What you mean by bad habits?
Like, in bad habits, if you're sitting there just, like, sitting there clicking, you're not vocalizing with your opponent. And I think, like, a good reason why I got really good really fast is because I vocalized everything. Like, I didn't, from playing Billy, he taught me, like, the open game states and everything. You just, like, basically talk to your opponent until, like, their ears bleed. But it, like, solves, it solves so much communication issues.
Yeah, there's no problems. And, you always know what phase you're in.
There shouldn't be problems anyway.
Yeah, when you're playing online.
Inner battle phase.
Yeah, but people don't
hold
do
on,
that.
I have a response. Well, sure.
She's speaking from, like, a mental game.
Oh, to, like, outplay your opponent with, like, your voice?
No.
Before I was playing, like, only online, like, there would be a lot of, like, miscommunication issues. Like, a lot of them will try to, like, you know, like, shark or, like, lie to your judge or whatever. Like, just to get it because you're not vocalizing it.
You're not used to the physical interaction.
Yeah, but if you say,
speaking.
Like, you know, activate this, and your response, okay, resolve. And on DN, you break out of those habits because you're just clicking.
Yeah.
Playing in person just put me into all those positions. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, there's a lot. Well,
like, you can do both. It's not like one or the other. Like, I would play online, and it would.
Yeah, but you're not physically
set
signing
up for
opponent.
A tournament.
What? Sort of. I mean, it's just different. It's different playing someone online than playing someone physically in a tournament and speaking to another individual as opposed to just typing. I mean, it's why we joke around now, and every time I activate a monster's effect, I go, swap frog, F, because it's a joke from typing the tournament.
Yes, but
F.
It's
F,
good online
F.
because you see so many situations, different situations that you wouldn't
but
see.
I don't,
it's just like
I'm not,
any other
we're not
game.
Arguing. I'm not arguing. At least I'm not arguing the competitive aspect of it.
I just want everybody to be the best that they can be.
Yeah, that's why.
That's what makes a game amazing.
Yeah.
Like there's games that are just so popular because the people that are so good, they're so fun to watch because they're so good at what they do.
The thing is, there could be a point where there can be no game because all these hobby shops are dying. No one's going to their.
Yeah, if all the locals die, like, and it kills. Like,
this game is not dying. For
no,
what
I don't
it's
think
worth,
no.
This game is not
it's
dying.
It's not, but it is a potential. It did see a huge decline, like, while the other one was up. And then when it went down, the game did pick up a lot.
Working at hobby shops, you saw it, like, the change, like, the drastic change of people coming in locally.
It was bad.
Yeah, locals were.
It was bad. It was a joke. Why would we go to locals when I get.
But still, there was.
People would go to locals and play
on. There was a 5,000 person tournament with the old emulator.
Yeah, with the old emulator. Yeah, cool.
The biggest tournament we ever
had. Yeah, we
had
a 5,000. We had a 5,000 person tournament in real life, too.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. But I'm saying.
With the online simulator. While it existed, there was a 5,000 person tournament.
But yeah, it's just an interesting conversation. You have to realize, like, you don't have to just be on whatever side. Like, it doesn't make a difference, really. Just know that, like, you know, if you love the game, that's really all that's important.
The last thing I want to say is, like, when I played online, I got way better because I got to, like, communicate with other people that I wouldn't get to play with in real life from other parts of the world.
Scott, no,
I'm just trying to defend the online community, you feel me? Because
you're defending them from no attack.
There is an attack. There's 100% an attack. There was an attack. Yes.
There's not an attack.
There was an attack, all right?
I think there's a definite increase in local John? Play since, like...
Yeah, I know. Oh, that's a good thing.
John,
yeah.
Since you just...
All right, next subject. Okay. Next subject.
Oh,
Scott's getting a little...
It's just, it just irritates me.
I never... Yeah, it's nothing about being competitive. It's just about keeping the game alive and...
But it's not dying.
Yes, but it, makes, okay. It is a negative impact upon it.
We've had the highest attendance at all events since it's gone.
Yes, but in the highest attendance of all time while it was still around. So what's the difference?
When was it still around?
Long Beach.
But sort of.
5,000 people were there.
That's also 100,000. Special event. It's also not about the one specific. It's about more so about local attendance, not about OYCS attendance. But locals definitely were struggling, and everywhere across the country.
Okay.
But anyways, moving on. The last subject that we had to talk about. We're just going to talk about
what was it?
Disrespectful opponents and how to deal with them.
I'm gonna sit out of this one. Yeah, because I'm pretty disrespectful.
So Scott is one of the people you'd have to deal with sometimes when you are
no,
playing.
No, that's not true.
Sometimes
that's
Scott,
not true. That's
just
not true.
Know you go to your pairings and you happen to see that Scott Robertson.
No, that's not
page,
true. That's not true.
And just know you have to prepare yourself a little bit. He might give you a little an earful before the game even
that's
starts.
That's not true. That's not true at all. But go ahead.
Oh, okay.
I heard in California. Oh my gosh, is that Scott Page?
Yeah, the people.
No, just kidding. Crazy. Scott's really nice.
I'm nice.
I don't know. Scott got a little.
What happened?
He's nice to get
Scott was a good sport when we played.
Yeah, she destroyed me. And I smiled.
Scott,
shook her
yeah,
hand,
no, Scott was
match.
Just like.
Oh. And good luck the rest of the day.
I hope you do really well the rest of the tournament. It was a pleasure playing you.
Yeah, Sam Mateo, you spit in my face while eating Chinese. Remember, you spit in my face while eating Chinese food.
It was an accident.
And I sat there politely listening to your entire story. Before I wiped it off my face.
Weird. Okay,
I didn't remember that. I forgot about it.
Yeah, sometimes you have to play people who are a little disrespectful. But you have to know the best way to kill them is with
kindness.
Gotcha. Kill them with kindness. Put a smile on your face. Let them know. Are you having a bad day?
Billy,
no.
Not
like that.
Do as I say, not as I do. But no, you want to try and be nice. Everyone has to play against disrespectful people every now and then.
It just looks at Scott when he says
I'm what? Super nice.
Super
online,
nice.
I'm a jerk. Just because it's fun.
But so another another thing online is bringing out all the jerks and all the
wait, no XYZ, no pendulum, no synchro, no fusion, no anything.
Those people don't exist.
But they do.
They're only
online.
They exist in real life. They also don't exist. Period. Because they're just.
Yeah,
anyway,
you know, now that I think about it, all the disrespectful people I played against were online.
Weird.
Because guess what? They're behind a screen. They think they can say anything.
Yeah, so this does tie into our last
subject. You know,
if anybody was wronged by Swordmaster.
It spreads negativity.
Spreads negativity, and we only want positive vibes in these parts.
No one's going to be mean to you IRL unless, like, they're the one.
No,
unless they're the one in, like, you know, 20 people.
Yeah, I'd like to see them try.
Everyone on DN was mean. Everyone on DN was super mean.
Yep. Anything to say about disrespectful opponents?
Just if you start the game right, then you probably won't like have a disrespectful opponent.
There are just people that are dicks.
You never had that guy sit across from me and you're like, "Hey man, I'm Billy. It's nice to meet you." And they're like, and they just take their deck out and just keep looking at you, and you're just. I'm just trying to shake their hand, man. You ever had that?
I got that
issue?
A couple times.
Too shy to even be rude at that point.
Oh, you're just smiling. You just Deuce. I've never seen Deuce without a smile on his face. This guy's like, it's he's never even noticed you're getting disrespected. You're just like, I'm here to duel.
Is that me at the casino though?
Yeah, that was definitely.
Apparently, I was just getting disrespected all day, and the entire time, I'm just like, I just like to play.
I don't like sharks, but. That's about as disrespectful.
No, if your opponent is playing a shark, let them know by giving them the old big jaw signal.
I got shark in the
shark,
and it was just like
how'd that
such
feel?
A terrible feeling. But
remember to activate your.
And he was playing cleese. He had to shark me.
Scott, tell us about your tournament experience.
What, at nationals?
Yeah.
Okay, so like I pendulum summoned pendulum sorcerer.
Nice.
And like I targeted my scales, or something happened. Anyway,
you got magical springs.
Okay, you're doing what your deck does.
Yeah,
okay.
I targeted my scales. They both popped. I searched a lizard draw, and then I was just like sitting there thinking, and I just forgot to get. Guitartle, right? And I put my deck down. I was like, oh, I forgot Guitartle. He's like, nope, you missed it. And I was like, what are you talking about? He's like, no, you missed it. And I was like, no.
That's just the card resolving
my effect. And then we went on for like a good 2 or 3 minutes. He's like, you know what? Let's roll for it. And I was like, no, I'm getting my card.
Let's roll for it.
Like,
nice.
What? I'm going to shark you, but we're going to roll for it. So that just people that look for free wins, it's just...
You got to deal with it sometimes so in annoying. Any game.
So this one was when people check on wavering eyes.
Oh, yeah, they're like, oh, you resolved the second one first, sorry.
Oh, the order? Yeah. Oh, no, I would literally just have to look at him and be like, oh, sorry, no, I didn't. I didn't write down this 500. I haven't done that part yet. Or is that the first thing you resolved?
I don't even know. I can't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember, but yeah,
but when people are sharking you, stand your ground. Yeah. Stand your ground, people.
Be you're nice, though.
Don't let anyone
oh, don't be nice.
Stuff.
I don't be nice.
See, I told you he wasn't nice. No, I told you he wasn't nice.
If you're nice to me, I'm nice to you. If you're a prick, I would just be a prick back to you. It's just the way the world works.
I kind of just tell my opponents to shut up sometimes.
Could you please be quiet?
No, it's like they're being like super mean. Stop. And they're being like super like, they'd be
can
like,
you,
ugh.
Can you not do that?
There was one guy. Excuse me, guy. I don't remember what, one nationals.
Excuse me, guy. Are you in one nationals? Yeah.
It was the nationals, the Necroz nationals. It was like 5-0.
The BA nationals.
Let's hear it. What were the finals?
Huh, the BA. What happened that day?
The BA continues.
The finals of the freaking nationals. Anyway, so.
No
so
green.
This guy,
oh, what's up, Noah?
This guy just kept like, he just kept losing his board and he just was complaining the entire time. I'm like, I'm sorry, would you not like me to play Yu-Gi-Oh?
Yeah.
Why enter a Yu-Gi-Oh tournament if you don't like the, you know, the competitive like aspect that. That of good. It?
That was good.
Why are we playing right now?
I never even mistaked the guy. There's no reason for him to be upset. Exactly. I'm like, I'm gonna activate my fire. Like, he's like, huh! You have everything. I'm like,
no, we not use my card.
Yeah.
Just get destroyed.
I wish I could have got fire leg to that tournament.
Yeah, for real. What are you gonna fire leg? You're fucking
all going my
mouth. Oh man, how did that deck win? Anyway,
it was good. It was good. Yeah, mistake.
It was a mistake.
Staked anyone that weekend. I just fiended them.
Fiended. Oh, the hands. The fire and ice hand were so good to that tournament.
Yo, those cards were super good.
Those are my fire and ice
you
hands.
You went cross-eyed there for a second, really?
Well, that's all I got. That's all I got. Oh, wait, no, we got to forget. We always have the one. Hold on.
Get me out of here.
Oh, my name.
Yep. John, any last thoughts? Anything you want to talk about? John?
We actually did a video, and it got really, really big, really fast, over 10,000 views. In
oh, are you
minute.
Talking about my player profile video that you can go watch now?
The Scott Page player profile.
Oh, yeah.
Right. What, is it from 2009? No, 2009 is too early.
I can't remember where it's from.
So,
anyway, sorry to interrupt you, John.
Go check it out.
It's basically like just
leave
creating
a
fun
like,
way
subscribe.
To play current Yu-Gi-Oh! So it like supports the current Yu-Gi-Oh! But it's limiting
oh,
all the cards to one. Yeah, it's Highlander from Magic. Basically,
they've done
it.
That's
Commander.
Before.
Yeah,
it's
I
really
said
fun.
It was Commander.
It's Commander,
but
it's
a Highlander.
Highlander
yeah.
in
I bet it's
G-O.
Broken now. Yeah, the ABCs yeah. was a good ad.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody's
ABC
deck is always
cool
the same.
But our twist is it has to be 60 cards. We're not gonna unban any cards, and we're gonna run a whole tournament on it. So it's gonna be kind of fun.
Dude, everybody's decks are gonna be the same. That's,
yeah, that's what usually happens.
There's so many. Actually, all the entrants have like told me different deck ideas. Like, oh, I think BA is gonna be really good. I think Paleo is really
good
here.
Throw them on.
Like, people are like, Pals were made for this. It's just really cool to see so many different ideas.
I'm gonna have my Yuma deck ready.
This is
Yuma.
Tight. The extra
yeah.
deck, I'm sure. Is
yeah, and the Zoo engine is just crippled since you only have the one Moon Barrage.
I'm down for
bet.
That.
You still play one Barrage.
So we're gonna do that after the current Zodiac tournament finishes up, and we'll have a completely free tournament for that. So that'll be fun.
Sweet.
And besides that, again, like, there was a video release that actually got taken down, basically saying the community sucks.
Who? excuse me?
Who did that?
Let me tell you.
But he took it down. He took
yeah,
it down.
Okay.
Who is he, though?
I'll have my words on it.
Another YouTuber.
Oh,
another YouTuber.
No shout-outs here.
One of the bigger YouTubers.
No
but,
shout-outs here.
Basically, again, I wanted to stress, like, the community is a super positive place. I've seen so many good things. I've seen, like, stuff out of bad situations where there were bad people in the community, like decks getting stolen, to where the kid gets his entire like deck replaced by the community. There's
shut
a lot
up,
of good. Don't let like one bad person out of 20 like ruin something because there's still those 19 good people there.
That was nicely said, John. I'm gonna shake your hand for that one.
Oh, I just want to be a part of something.
We are a part of something. Something great, really. The Yu-Gi-Oh! Community.
Yes! Hey, yes! Hey, hey. Only you can stop a forest fire or make the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community great.
I really
same
hope that
thing.
Camera's not on.
Oh, it's on. I'm
really
looking at you, America.
Camera.
Okay, Smokey. Yeah, the bear.
Smokey the bear. What's up, Billy?
Sup.
Hey, boo-boo.
Sup,
wow,
bro.
About a picnic basket or two?
Okay. All right,
so let me tell y'all something.
All right,
so,
tell us something.
What
tell
is
something.
After hours?
Let me tell you what.
For being in this community for inf years,
I've been in this community for inf years.
The worst side of the community. Yeah. But my God.
There's a good side.
The best side actually just outweighs the good
the bad side, yeah. Yeah, the positive.
I agree. My best friends on earth play this game.
Like yeah,
when,
me too.
When hey, Billy.
Yeah, once in a while they show up and come by.
Oh wow!
When they live 5 minutes away.
What are you saying?
Oh, when Amanda yeah. and I got our house broken into, like everyone that like helped us out was the Yu-Gi-Oh community, and
that's good.
She has all her stuff back.
Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, it was great. Only you can make an impact, and everyone can make an impact. Don't think that you won't matter because you do matter.
Yeah, I've heard like. I've
unless
heard
you're one of those
Exodia, no Exodia, no BA.
Unless
oh,
you're one
yeah,
of those
no, no.
guys,
well,
those people don't exist.
One of the people that like donated to like to the thing when
yeah.
it, all of it was this guy that Amanda ended up helping out years ago.
Yeah, you never
with,
know.
Like, something
that's cool.
like
you never know what impact like, you can leave on someone else.
Yeah, she like helped him out with like or something about it getting it stolen, and they just like gave back because you know. They're in a position to help out.
Yeah,
that's
they're
all
like,
that matters.
Yep, it's all that matters. You never know what little small tiny act of kindness you can do and what kind of impact it'll leave on the person that you do it to.
Mm-hmm.
Some of us are better people than others. And that's okay. I still accept anyone and everyone.
What the hell?
Whoa, where did that come from?
What?
Oh, okay, so is that it? Does anyone else have anything to talk about? Are we done for this week? Are we going to hold our breath for Scott next week when we can talk about the best players of all time?
Oh, man. That's going to be so
not,
much fun.
You're not
going
to.
I will be doing a probably like.
It doesn't matter what you'll be doing.
All right.
Sorry.
I will do a spoiler alert who my number one is. My boy, Patrick Hovind.
Where's my Road to the King book?
Oh, start man. Reading, Billy.
Start
so,
reading. We'll probably, since I'm staying home from Seattle, either Thursday or Friday night, or both perhaps, I'm probably going to do like a YCS Seattle pre-stream. YCS.
Dude, sometimes
did you hear that?
Sometimes you just pronounce something
Yo,
wrong.
Run it back. Did
sometimes
you say
YCS? Sometimes when you pronounce something and you start to feel a little burp come on and
sure.
you're talking a lot, it happens. Shout out to carbonated water.
Billy, absolutely no shout out to carbonated water. Sparkling water. If they ever offer you sparkling water, politely and aggressively decline. It is not something to benefit you. It is something to ruin your day and make.
It has ruined my day before.
How do you drink water and then immediately have to burp? It's not okay. It's not quenching your thirst. Right. There is nothing good about it.
So
sorry.
There will be a YCS Seattle pre-stream. And Scott's scared. I can't even talk.
Oh, go
Scott,
ahead.
Scott's scared of me now.
Go ahead.
All right, so there's going to be a pre-stream, and we're just going
to... A pre-stream?
Pre!
That's disgusting.
You're talking about butts and piss.
No, I'm not. Pre!
You're gonna get banned
pre.
From Twitch with all this nasty stuff you're going to do.
We're not even on Twitch.
What's good, YouTube and Twitch? We're here today with now you'll know where it comes from. It's John's favorite Yogi Bear impression. What's good, YouTube and Twitch? How about
anyway, John, if you have anything not nasty
so,
to say.
YCS Seattle pre-stream.
Oh, pre.
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 Yeah, so YCS Seattle will be streamed. That's going to be awesome if you didn't know.
Is it really?
Sure
is it going to be totally awesome?
Yeah. Totally awesome.
Totally.
But get me out of here. We're going to do all of our own Twitch incentives, and so you can get me drunk again, do whatever. We'll be raising money.
Wait, how much did it cost to get you in a tank top?
$10.
Leave me alone. Wow. How do you live with yourself?
Wow!
I would wear one anyway!
That's what the shots are for. The shots have to come after the tank top.
Oh, God. Is this just before or after you pee everywhere? Why
YCSP stream?
I think y'all are killing you.
God. What is wrong with you, John?
All right, this is how it ends.
I'm so happy I'm in
a clip. No. We're never
coming. I haven't even finished.
Oh, you're talking?
You're still peeing?
Jesus. Is it time for
positivity in the community?
Is it time to start round one for
Maybe Cap G was right. Anyway, John, do you want to finish whatever you're trying to start? Whatever that is?
I don't know if they can see it.
Are we done?
We're done.
Well, good luck at the YCS.
Bye, guys.